If there's such a thing as the warrior archetype, is there such a thing also as the warrior sense of humor? I mean, can we say that over all centuries and all lands, all armies, that there's kind of a common sort of dark, gallowsy sense of humor that soldiers seem to share no matter what? And I think that there is. And I think that there's a reason for it and that it serves a specific purpose. And if we think about the Spartans, if you think about Plutarch wrote an actual book, Sayings of the Spartans and Sayings of the Spartan Women, because he was kind of preserving these kind of quips and these one-liners. So today, what I want to do is I want to deconstruct two of these quips, both of which we talked about before, true historical things that were said at Thermopylae, at the Battle of Thermopylae, and see if we can understand what they have in common and why this sort of thing is important. And the first one is King Leonidas's last words to his men on the morning of the final morning of the battle, when they all knew that they were going to die and he knew that he was going to die. And what he said was, "Now men, eat a good breakfast, for we'll all be sharing dinner in hell." The second wisecracker one-liner is the one of Deinikas, the Spartan Deinikas, when on the earliest day of the battle, when they learned that the Persian archers were so numerous, they heard that when they fired their volleys, the massive arrows blocked out the sun. And so Deinikas said, "Good, then we'll have our battle in the shade." Now let's see if we can deconstruct those two. First of all, the thing to remember, I think, if you've ever been in a state of anticipatory fear, and somebody has a great quip or a great one-liner, just kind of breaks the fear and brings everybody together in that situation. And I think that's what this was all about. The Spartan sense of humor was not jokey. These were not like real laugh lines, even though everybody laughed. But the thing to remember here, I think, is that when you're in a state of anticipatory fear, what happens is each individual kind of withdraws into their own self. You know, they feel separated from their brothers and their comrades, and they start to think, my family, I'm going to lose my family, I'm going to lose my life, my family's going to be bereft of me, et cetera, et cetera. People pull in. That's the worst thing you want, is for each individual to become, you know, in their own little cylinder of fear. The second thing that happens, I think, when you're in a state of anticipatory fear is you start to think about, well, how can I get out of this? Is there anything I can do, anything I can say, you know, that can save me? And so again, a remark needs to bring a person out of that. So let's talk about these two for a second. One, "Now eat a good breakfast, men, for we'll all be sharing dinner in hell." And the other one, "Good, then we'll have our battle in the shade." One of the things, the first thing that these remarks do is they don't sugarcoat anything. They offer no hope. You know, both of these kind of say, we're going to face death, we're going to die, that's it. And this, I think, is tremendously empowering because it's the truth. You know, if at that moment, either of these gentlemen, Leonidas or Deinikas, had given a kind of a pep talk or a rah-rah speech or something with hope in it, it would have fallen completely flat and it would have demoralized everybody. So when they face the darkest reality and just tell it like it is, this is very empowering to the individual. The second thing that they do, and this is really important, is that both of these quips talk about we instead of I. And so it pulls the individual out of his own little cylinder of fear and back in with the group. So Leonidas says, "Now eat a good breakfast, men, for we'll all be sharing dinner in hell." He will be too. Same thing with Deinikas' remark. "We'll have our battle. We'll have our battle in the shade." So I think that these two aspects, the facing the fear without any sugarcoating whatsoever, and the second part of bringing it all together, that we're going to face this all together, kind of brings the warrior, the individual warrior, to a sort of a, it's a dark place, it's a gallowsy place, but it's a place that faces the reality squarely and I think produces courage. And that's what these quips were about. That's why Spartan boys were trained from a very early age to say the most they could in the fewest words possible and with an edge of humor if they possibly could.